Professor comigo. Professor comigo.
Puerto Rican Joe from the West Coast. Raised around essays and black folks. I never really fit in, but the G code made me call storms El Nino. Comprendo. Comprende, sorry, my English. Always been better, so I speak me some Spanglish. My mama never really taught it to me, so I learned it on my own. See, I barely understood it, but I still connected more to the street bangers. Wear my favorite color in the street banging. Adolescent trouble had me really active. See, the essays didn't like me, we was always scrapping. Black folks didn't like that, I had nigga ad-libs. Think I'm from Japan, that's another chapter. I just speak truth when I am in the booth. Sprinkle with some love and fertilize our bare fruit.
Si quieres así, then papi believe. Si tú quieres así, then mommy believe. Si tú crees así, profesar conmigo. Si tú crees así, profesar conmigo. Profesar conmigo.
Puerto Rican Joe from the West Coast. Verse number 3, see I'm blessed, bro. I can't believe I'm alive, writing cliff notes. Showing off these rhymes and trying to catch me a Holy Ghost. See them demons, they at me trying to take all my semen. I barely quit popping them pills and sipping lean. I dare you to try it, nigga, I feel so freely. Now the devil, he watch it, homie, I see him creeping. Yeah, that's what happened, homie, when God got you. I'm paying it forward now like a stock option. I'm lifting my niggas up like a blue Watson. While the music plays the trail, Lil McCollum. It be cool a big pun, watching me smiling. Already know my family is, got me excited. I just speak truth when I am in a booth. Sprinkle with some love and fertilizer, I bear fruit.
Si tu quieres así, then papi believe. Si tu quieres así, then mommy believe. Si tú crees así, profesar conmigo. Si tú crees así, profesar conmigo. Profesar conmigo.
Puerto Rican Joe from the West Coast. West Coast. Puerto Rican Joe from the West Coast. West Coast. Puerto Rican Joe from the West Coast. West Coast. I think I'm from Japan. That's another chapter. Chapter.
Puerto Rican Joe from the West Coast. West Coast. Puerto Rican Joe from the West Coast. West Coast. Puerto Rican Joe from the West Coast. Sprinkle with some love and fertilize the bear fruit.
Spanglish. 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 That's Spanglish. Shout out to Tim, shout out to Hitman for this dope ass mix. Shout out to my familia, Puerto Rico.
Spanglish.
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 Spanglish. Spanglish.
I told God to take the pain away. He told me he ain't finished trying to operate. Told him he might help with your pain. He said he almost done, he about to make a way.
I told God to take the pain away.
Believe it. When you experience it for yourself, we can then start preaching. These are words to speak to myself when I'm feeling beneath. See how many times I done backslid, you go ask for Titi Leach. I'm sick and tired, being sick and tired. Things I can't control, get me really fired. Like a Dutch dragon with a flame pack and a rust pack with a backwood and a sack good every time, G. Save my family and my time tree. Yeah, but hit field with an iron B and it sharpened well like a crown piece. See, molding us like a crown piece. That's my guy, he'll come and find you. In your darkest place to remind you. Someone got it way worse than I. Life's a trip, but she's so remindful. Lesson learns in a page turn. In a book of life, this is like yours. And I just yearn to help you do better life. I told God, take the pain.
He always picking me up in that new Tesla truck, giving me juice, charging me up. He's my plug, he's my source. I don't really need the five mic, I just really need to rhyme tight and show you the Lord and all of his might. Haters grab some pom-poms, we gon' pray for them on sight. You know how it go when I'm on the road, I'm always showing love, that's right.
I pray for my haters almost every day now. My neighbor is my brother from another set.
If you
try and cross me, he gon' strike it dead down. It's time to be bold, but our faith is proud. See, it's lessons learned in a page turned in a book of life. This is like yours, and I just yearn to help you do better life. I told God, take the pain away. He told me he ain't finished trying to operate. Told him he my hero, help me bear the pain. He said he almost done, he about to make a way. I told God, take away the pain. He said he almost done, he about to make a way.
He move offshore, he all pick me up in that new Tesla truck. Give me juice, charge me up. He's my plug, he's my source. Always keep me on course, yeah.
I told God, take the pain away. He told me he ain't finished trying to operate. Told him he's my hero, help me bear the pain. He said he almost done, he about to make a way. I told God, take away.
Niggas throwing down the H and shit.
Alright.
Hoochie mamas.
Mm.
Nigga, we from HTO. HTO.
On hustle.
We from HTO. HTO.
On hustle.
Niggas, HTO. HTO.
On hustle.
We from HTO. HTO.
On hustle.
This is HTO. HTO.
On hustle.
From HTO. HTO.
On hustle.
Niggas, HTO. HTO.
On hustle.
New HTO. HTO. HTO.
Niggas acting tough. Like they Tupac. Little niggas, get your ass shot like Tupac. 50 on my wrist and little bitch, and it don't TikTok. Niggas claim they gangsters, but be dancing all on TikTok on the H. You ain't leaving wake. HIP, my nigga Trey. SK, leave that nigga stink. Hot like we baking cake. Fuck that nigga bitch while he think that she on a blade. Pay me all my fee, and I ain't tricking, and that's on the game.
Yeah, I'm from Las Vegas, but the trenches. My gun like my bitch, she keep extensions. No Christmas, we the Grinches. We up, so we thugging on the benches. Swag band dope, no Homer Simpson. Forgot to mention. Thank God, cause he done bless me, nigga. Don't test me, nigga. Bro, running, I'ma stretch him, nigga. Peace resting, nigga. Can't wait till I catch him, nigga. Boom, fetch him, nigga. Revolver, Ruger, tech him, nigga. Boom. This HTO, and I'ma slide for the click. A drop for the click. A double homicide for the click. I shoot till I click. Got it from Bargain Pawn off a bitch. I never had shit.
Hey, it's Deacon T back here at the Hot Seat with Icy Jones for this week's Hot Topic with Deacon T. The topic today is about responsibility. And I think about the Bible whenever I come up with these hot topics and think about things I've been reading. And I was thinking about specifically how Jesus was given this responsibility that was undoubtedly the worst thing any of us could ever know, that you have been lied about, crucified, killed, just played with pretty much your whole life just so that other people could have a better life forever. So that the whole purpose of your life was to do good forever for other people. And when you think about the size of that responsibility, clearly only God and his son could pull that off. So then I start thinking about you and me and our responsibilities and how when you look at them in that context, our responsibilities actually are quite small and quite simple and quite mundane. But for whatever reason, speaking for myself, and maybe this applies to you, maybe it doesn't, but many, many times I don't live up to the responsibilities that have been given to me. Taking care of my family, taking care of my children, taking care of my job, my family members, and particularly doing right by myself, taking care of my, not getting too high, not drinking too much, not eating too much, not serious, not being too crazy. and taking care of myself so that I can take care of the other people around me. Because, and this is not a bad thing. People think, oh, you ego person and you all that. There's nothing wrong with taking care of yourself appropriately. Because if you don't take care of yourself, how in the world are you going to take care of all the people around you who you love and want to take care of and help out? How can you live up to your responsibilities if you don't take care of yourself? If Jesus had become a stumbling down, burnt out drunk, how would he have been able to lead other people? How would he have been able to get up and preach articulately?
Say that.
How would he have been able to set an example for other people to live by? So I'm here to say this. If Jesus is the example, knowing that we could never be that good, I'm just asking you to be partway good. I'm just saying, you know what? Start with yourself and take care of yourself. Be responsible for the vessel that your parents created that God gave them. That would be you. Don't get way overweight. Don't get too high. Don't get too drunk. Don't get too stupid. You know, balance yourself out. Practice being good to yourself. Pray, fast, meditate, work out a little bit, back off smoking, back off drinking, back off getting high. All those things. Why is it important? Because someone is relying on you, and you may not even know that yet. You may not know that there is somebody who's going to need you to be a better you next year, next month, 5 years from now. There may be somebody out there who you don't know of, they don't know you, who may be in your future destiny, and you need to have your stuff together so that you can take care of them. I had no idea 30 years ago that I would meet my wife, that we would have three wonderful children, that I would have to be a responsible guy. I was living the single life, thought I was cute, just popping my fingers and going around being silly, all impressed with myself. And then God sent me an angel and sent me three wonderful children with that angel. And because of that, I had to be responsible. I had to do right by my wife. I had to do right by my children. I had to get up and go to work. I had to hold a job. I had to moderate my lifestyle. I had to do all those things because that was the responsible thing to do. It was the godly thing to do. It was the right thing to do. So I'm challenging each and every one of you today. When you think about your life, when you think about how you're living, even if you don't think you have anybody in your life that you need to be responsible for, you're responsible for yourself, and you answer to God for how you treat the vessel he gave you. But I'm here to challenge you because you don't know what the future holds. You don't know who's around the corner waiting for you to be a better person than you are today, waiting for you to be standing on your own two feet. And if you're somebody who's been blessed, and I'm going to put this out there, I'm going to just talk to the men today, but it applies to men and women. If you are out there and you've been blessed, which we all have, we have a responsibility to God to do something with the blessings we've been given. If you've been given health, if you've been given a little bit of money, if you've been given a good job, if you've been given a wonderful home life, a great spouse, then we have a responsibility to take that blessing and do something with it. Excuse me. If you don't think that's true, look up in the Bible about the man who went away and gave his servants 5 talents, 3 talents, 1 talent. I don't care what you have or what you can do. Your job is to take what God's given you and put it to work. Start with yourself and then expand to others. So I see's back. So that's the word for today. Yes, you want to catch me on Sundays on Deacon Tom Moore on the Facebook page at 10 a.m. Pacific time every Sunday morning. We'll bring you some good word, Bible-based. It'll be contemporary and hip. And I try to be short, and it'll be cool. I promise you that. I'm going to let a little secret out today. You can also get us on roomserviceradio.com.
Yep.
I'm going to let a little secret out today. Okay, we don't have it all planned out yet.
Okay.
But we're going to do, you know, we are 100% online now.
Yes.
Since COVID.
Yes.
We are planning sometime this summer.
Yes.
An event.
Okay.
A Modern Word Ministries event.
Let's go.
Where we're going to have real music, a real band.
Yeah.
I'm going to lean on a guy I know who's a gospel rapper. He and have him do something. We're going to have some other people do something.
Yeah.
And I'm going to do something I really love to do and I really miss doing. And that is I'm going to put some live word on 250 people.
Yes.
So, we'll let you know when it is, but I want the buzz to start.
Yes.
We're going to do this live thing. I'm going to get a spot. We're going to rent it out. It's going to be at a cool time, like a Friday evening or something, you know.
Right.
Come out, bring the family, yeah. And I'm going to start praying now that the Holy Spirit give me something that would just light 250 people on fire.
Let's do it, man. Let's do it. I want you guys to remember to go get this book, man. Please go get Joys.
Absolutely.
In Absence of a Mother. It's only $25, man. It's $24.99 on Amazon. It's written by Stanley Bernard Harris III and co-written by Mary Ann Santos Harris, which is his lovely wife. Man, again, Joys in Absence of a Mother. It's really just about that mother, man. You know what I'm saying? Like he lost his mother and he realized, wow, there's a lot of things I didn't get to do and say and questions and.
I can't even imagine
this book.
Knowing how my mother impacted me so. I mean, my mother was everything to me.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah.
And I can't. I was crushed when she left.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was a grown man.
Right.
You know.
Right.
I cannot even imagine what I would have missed had she left when I was older, like this guy did.
Yep.
Brutal.
So make sure you guys, please, go get Joys in Absence of a Mother. I have 4 copies, so if you want to meet me at the station on a Friday between 12 and 2, you can come get a book. I do have 4. Just let me sell 4 books for them, you know what I'm saying? And then let's keep it pushing, you dig? Anyway, man, we about to play Block in the Building while Block come in the building. Let's go.
Yeah. It's the Block back in the studio. One time for that mom.
These are so fresh.
It's the block in the building. It's the block in the building.
Causing, man.
It's the block in the building. It's the block in the building.
Put your headphones on, man. Let's go. We got Block in the building. We got Block Tutti in the building.
That is I in the building.
In the flickety flash. What's happening, my guy?
Oh, man. Chilly, man. It's good to see you, baby.
You too, man. It's been some time.
It's been a long, it's been some time, but you know, every time I see you, I remember how far we go back. Boy, Sunday school, second grade, I'm talking about St. Paul Church
I'm
of God in Christ.
Hell you, man.
And it's really a beautiful thing. I wanted to say that, you know what I'm saying? It's a beautiful thing, man. I see Jones still with my God.
Yes, sir.
It's all God. It's all love, too. Yes, I be deep in my Bible, and, 100%. You know, it's. That's a beautiful thing, man.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it, man. Look, man, I know we got some time. We got about 30 minutes with you, man.
For sure.
You feel me? But your song been playing every week.
That's what's
for
up.
For the month.
That's mm-hmm. banging.
You
know banging.
Understand me?
It's banging.
It's banging.
It's banging.
All right now.
Look, the first time we played it, it had ran back on his own.
Uh-huh.
And he thought it was I said, nah, that's him. He ran his own song back. Hold on, we gonna run his back. That was good though, man. I love
that's
it.
That's what's up. That's what's up. Thank you.
So I got a couple questions. You know how
okay.
I go, man.
Yes, sir.
Block to the.
That is I.
Where did that come from?
Okay, so when the person who gave me my name, you know, first met me, you know, he said to me, he was like, man, I gotta think about your name for a minute. Okay. You the homie. You know what I'm saying? And you definitely gonna kick it with the homies, but I gotta think about your name for a second. And you know, he was just looking, you know, we had sat down together for a second and he looked at me, because I was talking, and I think I was talking about something. He always used to comment on how I had a different perspective right. of things than everybody else that you he do. Used to talk to. He was like, you the homie, but you don't. Nobody thinks like you.
Yeah.
And he was like, you know what? It's like you hood. You can be hood, especially when you rap. It's like a different personality. And that's like one side of the tracks. And then, you know, you can sit down and have an intelligent conversation with somebody. That's another side of the tracks. And he say, I think about that like all four corners of the block. You can go up the block and talk to the candy lady.
Yeah.
Then you can go down to the block and talk to the dope dealer. Then you can go over there and talk to the broad. So he say, that's going to be your name. He said, Blocko. My hood name is Blocko.
Yeah,
but I say block to the, he said, block.
Yeah.
Because you all four corners of the block.
Yeah.
So,
got it. Got
yeah.
It.
So I just said, you know, I got jazzy with it. And I'm just like, block to the O. And I'm like, man, that's too long. Yes, I said, I just got
to the.
I just clipped the O. Mm-hmm. And then to the or toda in Spanish means everything. Look, I know. Toda means everything. And I'm studying Portuguese. Now.
Okay.
I'm learning Portuguese.
Okay.
So I'm like, that's perfect.
But
I just chopped the O.
Anything. Block to the what? Block to the left.
Block to the right.
Block to the.
That's
what I thought
everything.
About. He can do anything. Block
anything.
To
anything.
And you put the other one on it. You feel
yeah,
me?
Yeah.
And then when you put the O on it, I'm not going to lie, it ostracizes you, especially when we was coming up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
The section that said.
Right.
Can't really, you know?
Right.
So that was
which
good.
Which is part of the reason that I dropped it. I mean, everybody, as far as my stage name is
right.
concerned.
Right.
You know what I'm
Let's say that out loud.
As far as my stage name is concerned, I said, and I thought about that. I said, man, I can't.
Yeah.
I can, but Block has already got two C's behind it.
Yep. So you,
and I'm just like, it'd just be all the way to. So I got to kind of end it. I got to go industry a little bit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so I'm like.
A little bit.
Like, just not Block. So I'm Block to the O. Like, I said, just clip the O. Block to the.
Block to the.
Block to the.
There's nobody else. If I look that up, it's just you.
Exactly. You know, exactly, like, right?
Who you got sitting next to you, man?
This is my cat. This is my guy.
What's going on, man? Happy to be here.
Jay Lava in the building.
Wait, hold on. Put your hat down. Let me see that thing. Look at
Las
that thing.
With the Las Vegas Raiders hat on.
Yeah, you know, I think it's too much where you're from. It's kind of where you at.
Yeah.
I'm here like 3 years in from Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Welcome, welcome.
Where it's going up right now, the center of the uprising and revolution.
Yes,
you know.
Yes, you're right.
So my city's putting on right now. Hopefully they get their thing together. But
yeah.
I met this guy here.
Uh-huh.
First coming down here.
Okay.
Very tenacious individual.
You see? Absolutely.
Very. I was feeling his music so bad. I'm like, man, let me shoot a video for you.
Okay.
I'm trying to solidify myself down here because I'm a videographer, a photographer.
Yeah.
I have a podcast. I'm a producer. I'm an artist. I do a lot of things.
Yeah.
And he's good at all of them.
Yeah. Right. Well, like this right here, Keep It Pete Podcast is the podcast that I do. So me and him are on a collaborative effort right now to start some programming. I kind of dig his knowledge as far as rap goes. He's a very, very accomplished lyricist, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And he said he wanted to put some programming together as far as, like, rap history. So we're working together on that.
There you go.
And, you know, obviously on other things. What? Rap Battle League.
We got the Battle League. Yeah. He's, okay, so I own a Battle League.
Okay.
It's called Barcode Battle League Sin City.
Okay.
You can find it on YouTube.
Yeah.
We got the Facebook page.
Yeah.
We got the Instagram. And our first event... Jay Lava said, man, that got to be me, baby. That's got to have Jay Lava on it.
Okay.
So he came through. I gave him a boom mic, and the rest is history.
What you smell like, man? What you got on? You smell good.
Thank you.
What is that?
That's that Perry Ellis, baby. That's the original. That's the original Perry Ellis, baby. That's the original Perry Ellis. You got the Perry Ellis 360, which I do have it on. I'm a Perry Ellis fan.
Okay.
And I can't wait. Till I get my bread all the way up to where I want it, because I'm going online and I'm getting the vintage Perry Ellis.
Everything Perry Ellis.
I'm getting the vintage. No, I ain't doing everything.
But I know what you mean.
Yeah, it's Perry Ellis all the way down to the cologne. No, but that's the original. They got the popular Perry Ellis right now is the Perry Ellis 360.
Yeah.
And you'll see it. You remember. It's
the long bottle with the
circle
top.
Yeah, it's the long bottle.
Come on, baby.
Come on now. Come on now.
That's the popular 360, right? That's the popular Prairie Ellis right now, but that what you smelling right there, that's the original.
That's the thing.
The box. It's the box cologne.
Yeah, yeah, and it's the thing. We're going to clip that, and we're going to send that to Prairie Ellis. We're going to clip that piece right there.
Right, that's it.
You got to pay for that.
Endorsing y'all right there.
They got to pay for that.
For real.
Yes, sir.
So then, when did you come up, or not come up, but when did you get the name, the title, Mr. Hot 16 of the city, you know?
Okay, so there's a... there's a cat named Benny Franco. Shout out to Benny Franco. RNC. RNC. Oh, Real Niggas Incorporated. Yes,
Let's talk about it.
Yes.
History. Like you said. Hip-hop entrepreneur here. Let's go.
Yep. And he hosted a series of battles.
Okay.
He hosted a series of battles at a series of places a few years ago. And my partner, Eddie Fuse. Eddie Fuse used to come to it. He came to a couple of them.
Okay.
He came up to me one day after I had won. About I won all of the ones that he hosted.
I remember this.
I won every single Hot 16 battle he hosted.
I'm not doing that.
I won every single one he hosted.
He did.
And Eddie Fuse came up to me after about the third one, and he said, Block, man, can't nobody mess with you. Man.
Yeah.
He said, can't nobody mess with you. It's like you Mr. this... Right here, I say, Mr. Hot 16? Yes, it's like you Mr. Hot 16 of Las Vegas. I said, Fuse, so Fuse, you did that. You helped me come out. He'll remember, too. We were talking outside of the place. He said, man, dang, you can't nobody mess with you. I said, Mr. Hot 16. I say, how that sound? He said, that sound dope.
It sounds great.
And ever since then, I've been hashtagging Mr. Hot 16.
So can you please give me a Hot 16?
Give you a Hot 16. Yeah, okay.
I'll give you about 10 seconds to do it.
You know, ain't no 16. Let's ain't go, no 10 dude. Seconds. All right. My Coke's whiter than an Aryan's tone, just to make sure my business is running smoother than Marion Jones. I ain't a dog, but I'm burying bones for drought season, and I've never been a mason, but I'm carrying stones. I don't need no one to spare me alone, cause I'm in there like swimwear. I'm covered like the cherries and scones, man. You can never scare me, I'm on some real shit. So I fuck with real niggas, leave them fairies alone. I chew these rappers up like Copenhagen. There's no mistaking, the block is overtaking. All of these hoes is faking, hoes are shaking. From the moves that this pro is making, my hunger to be the best in the game is my motivation, and this dough I'm chasing. So hold your hating at a minimum. Control your statements, nigga, know your placement. Cause when it comes to me, there's no such thing as the critic that's overrating. I earn every plaque that I get. That's it, there's no debating.
Hey. That's why. And then it's not only that. You said tenacity. Like the thing is, you have a delivery.
Right, right.
Right?
Thank you.
No. You're welcome. But my thing is, that's why they love my performance as well. I see that. Like, we have to make movements with our face and mouth. And it's the delivery, though. That's a package.
It's gotta hit. And you know what? Cats from the West Coast, a lot of cats from the West Coast, lack that. Mm-hmm. That's why we kind of dropped back. We was hot when Pac and Snoop and it, but then we kind of dropped back because cats in Atlanta caught wind of it, and boom, it's the part of our delivery that we get from that. Now everybody know East Coast, the rap hip hop was born on the East Coast.
Yeah, we know that.
And then, you know, we caught wind of it and we took it to another level. We took it to gangsta rap and Eazy-E and Cube and Dre and N.W.A. came out here hard. Snoop, Pac. This is where cats like us from the West get the hit that a lot of cats that don't. Yeah. Game had it.
Yeah. But I think we're still 80s babies.
We are. But it's the hit. It's the dun 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 dun. And that's what a lot of West Coast rappers lack, because they don't understand that you got a hit like that. The East Coast, they animated. Sworn it ain't song, stick a figure. Sworn it's pawn, it ain't horn, and a ton, and a son, and a son, and a son.
You
got to hit, you have to hit on the beat, and you have to hit off of the beat to be a dope lyricist. It's got and that's where our movements come in, and that's why we have a dope. You got a dope delivery. You know, I've always, ever since I heard your first stuff, you know, I've always said, man, you dope. You are really dope. I got to put you on a cypher, too. I'm hosting a cypher. Shot by Hot Lava Music TV. That's my boy J Lava joint. It's our delivery, and that's where we get the, you have to be animated. West Coast, we so gangster that we don't want to do nothing. Like gangsters don't dance with boogie. On the West Coast, on the East Coast, they be,
it's a right.
And that's how they come on. A-Town, A-Town stuff, they caught wind of it, and they started doing that, and then it went to Miami, take it to the house.
Block.
You know what I'm saying?
Stop playing.
And we still, gangsters don't dance with boogie.
What's up? You hear any lies told?
You got something against Punk?
No. You're from the Midwest, though.
Well, I mean,
you had like Petey Pablo and Twista.
The Midwest is a culmination of all different type of rap styles. Me, myself, I lean towards more like the East Coast liking, but I definitely had all the West Coast too. I mean, I'm MC8, I'm Spice One.
You really?
Yeah. So, I mean, we mixed up, but. But then I'm Crucial Conflict, too.
Me, too.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? So, plus, I'm a producer, so I listen to all different types of music anyway. So, that just keeps me in the loop. But right now, I'm not really used to some of the newer programming. Not say I don't agree with the newer music out. I think that we just kind of under a different programming as far as generational.
You're right.
I think it's more that we were the hustlers, quote unquote, real niggas and all this tough stuff then. And now it's emo drug users.
It is.
But chopped and screwed.
Let's not act like we weren't drug users.
Yes.
But we wasn't chopped and screwed, though.
They were
chopped and screwed.
In our era, that came out.
Well, what Q say? Don't get high off your own supply.
Right.
What was the Ten Crack Commandments?
That's right.
Like they was promoting standing strong. Promoting, you know.
And that's junkies.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. Like, they was promoting junkies.
No, that's the word he wants. Gave it to him. Junkies.
Yeah.
But it's a new generation, man. And I feel like every generation, they lose something. Like, I know we didn't have what the 70s had.
True.
We weren't dressing in suits and ties. True. We was in the Fila suits and the fresh Adidas and all that, right?
Well, I beg to differ. I did bring that back. I am like the bow tie bandit. I did bring it back today.
Not today.
Well, right now I'm a walking billboard because I gotta be, you know.
You got your brand on, right?
That's right. You gotta show people that you gotta rock what you are.
Taught me that. You feel me?
Yes.
Master P, E-40.
We say that on our show every day. Master P taught us to get it on. That's why it's JLava.com, KeepItPPodcast.com, and TZVonSavage.com.
There you go.
Get your own.
So when it comes to Vegas, man, how do you feel about our sound block? Do you feel like we have a sound block? Because we deep in the game now. We some decades in the game now as a hip-hop culture.
We are. We are as soaking it up. And embracing. We've been embracing the culture for years and years to come.
Yeah.
But nobody knows that.
Yeah.
Because truthfully, we may have a sound, but we're the only ones who hears it. Nobody else hears it.
This is what he's saying. It's a majority rule, bro.
Yeah.
You can disagree, but the reality is only a few of our local artists have made it outside of the borders, is what we're trying to say.
Right.
So the majority rules, like majority people still here
and trying
to do the Instagram or YouTube thing.
And then we don't have lasting
power. But we have podcasts.
We don't have lasting power. We don't stay.
Yeah.
You had Quan did his thing for a second. Mm-hmm. He had a song with Snoop. He had a song with somebody else. He said, 702. Mm-hmm. They went in. They was behind Missy. But their first album was popping, and then the second one.
Where's the mainstream rapper? See, because 702 is mainstream. Neo, mainstream.
Yes.
Where the mainstream
Neo
rappers?
From here?
Neo went.
Just say yes.
He went to. Yeah.
He lived here.
He grew up here.
I never knew that. He wasn't born here.
He was born down south.
Okay.
If you ask him, he'll tell you he's from Vegas.
Dizzy
came up here.
Dizzy Wright is not a mainstream rapper, but he's a mainstream independent artist.
Okay.
Say that, right?
Right.
Okay. Where's the mainstream artist from Vegas? I've never seen one.
Because we don't come get each other.
Okay.
You see, and I bring up Atlanta because Atlanta popped on the scene and they blew up.
Just start.
And they stayed like that.
Everybody kept put. Yep.
You know why? Because they went and got each other.
They did.
And it's not that we don't love each other. It's not that we don't fuck with each other like that. It's not that we don't mess with each other. It's like that. It's just that it's a strategy and we haven't gotten it down yet.
Okay.
And that's once we get that strategy down,
yeah,
we'll have mainstream artists, but we don't have that strategy down yet.
Coming from Minneapolis, y'all music scene is way more popping than ours. It's more tight knit. I had an opportunity to meet a lot of bomb Vegas artists, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. I'm saying, I don't know why you ain't mentioned a few, like Yowda. I like him.
He's from Vegas, but he says it in Misfits. Misfits is doing big things, but Misfits, bro, I'm not saying we're not doing things. No, okay, even Yowda is a mainstream independent artist.
I wasn't born in the Bay.
All right, I get what you.
But it raised and it made me.
Yes, there you go.
He said that in Mindkind too.
And this is the reality.
Shout out to Yowda too. He's on my YouTube.
He's not.
There's a lot of people. I've had an opportunity to run into a lot of people.
It's a lot of people.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Rumzelli.
But do you know
I like Rumzelli.
Yep.
Mike Bleazy.
There is no Lil Baby.
Oh my God.
Right.
There is no 42 Doug from Las Vegas.
Right, okay.
42
right.
Doug is now on the charts.
Right.
Top 200 or 100. Lil Baby is number one with a bullet. It would have with a Drake feature, the first song he put out. That's what I mean. They went back and got their people from the trenches. Look, Young Thug went and got Lil Baby and said, I'll pay you to stay out the streets.
Exactly.
That's what he's saying right now when he says that's not what we're doing, even if they are up there. But I seen Yowda do things, but Yowda is only, he's under MMG. From what we see, I don't know Yowda personally, but from what I see, he's MMG, but he's still doing his own thing. It ain't like they just dumped the millions on him where he could just go get everybody and just put everybody on the charts. Right. Yowda not even on the charts like that.
Right.
I haven't even heard a song on 97 from Yowda like that. In rotation is what I'm saying.
Right.
Okay. And mind you, the views on my show is our opinions only. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. We like to spit facts. And you can go check out our opinions as facts. But at the same time, this is how we feel. This is what we we born and raised here from the mud. So this is what I see. Yeah. But when I look at Block, man, I see the same. I look at Block and see myself. He said we've been knowing each other since we was children.
Right.
And we grew up, and this is where we are today. You know what I mean? We're still in this music thing.
Mm-hmm.
We are the culture. We are the gatekeepers now, Block.
Right.
You feel me? You're going to be the gatekeeper of the Hot 16s. And you just tell me all the things you're doing.
Yep.
That's the gatekeeper stuff. But you had to do that. You had to get the title. You had to get the nickname from, you know, people had to put you on.
Right.
Now
it's
our turn. Now we older. We up. We professional. Let's put them on. That's why we're sitting here. Right.
I agree.
So that's what he's saying in Atlanta. But we got to build that now.
Yeah. You know, the other thing I think about Atlanta.
Yeah, no problem.
If you live anywhere in the South.
Mm-hmm.
You aspire to either be in Miami
or
Atlanta.
Yep, then the high spots.
Ain't no brother down there talking about, I think I'd go to Jackson, Mississippi when I get big. Okay, it just ain't happening like that.
Right.
And unfortunately, we way out here on the West Coast, and when people think West Coast, they think
California
in some way, but LA, right?
Right.
And because virtually, not quite, but virtually every major record label and music of any kind is headquartered or significantly headquartered, even if they're incorporated in New York. They're headquartered in Los Angeles. People are like, well, I'm already on the Southwest. Why stop in Vegas? I mean, you give me a reason. Is RCA Records headquartered there? Is Def Jam there?
No.
Is Death Row there? No. So why would I get off the plane?
Yep.
Right?
Yeah.
But in Atlanta, in New York, you know,
that's where it's at.
And in Miami.
That's where it's at.
Depending on your sound.
Yeah, and, you know, I just kind of touched on it, but, you know, and this is the thing. Like, everybody comes up, but I respect the way Atlanta came up, and here's a little bit more why, because we all witnessed it. The 80s babies, we witnessed it from Monica to Outkast all the way to T.I. We saw all of them just come up, Youngblood. All of them come up and they supported each other. It was a beautiful fucking movement.
Yeah.
It was a beautiful movement. Yeah. And they here to stay. They ain't going nowhere. All of them are still rocking today.
Okay. What I don't like is that people come here to die. People come to Vegas, like Teddy Riley or Albie Shore or these big names.
Right.
And they just come to retire. Right. Because, essentially, is to die.
That's because there are financial incentives to live here.
To live here.
Yeah. Yes. Right? No state income tax.
You're not looking.
Low property tax.
For the next Teddy Riley in Vegas. No. You're not looking for the next Albie Shore in Vegas or the next New Jack Swing Sound in Vegas.
Vegas,
and I mean that in a new day is what I'm saying.
Right,
right.
That's what makes me upset. Y'all here and y'all not rocking with us. Y'all not going to Mario's
Market. They're done.
You're not going down to Northtown.
They
they're not done. They still trying to do them on Instagram and do them and put out new stuff. But I'm not, this is not personal. I don't have a personal problem with them. But what I'm saying is, as the culture of music and hip hop and R&B, we need y'all to reach back. We live here.
You know, I think the other thing that is different, this is culturally different between Atlanta, for sure LA, but Atlanta, black people and urban music has money in Atlanta.
Oh, yeah.
There are people, black people, and I'm just keeping it real here. Black people are powerful, and there are lots of them. Many more so in terms of percentages than there live here in Las Vegas.
And to elaborate on that, Atlanta has the most black millionaires than anywhere in the United States.
Hello, somebody. Okay. So there's a reason. There's a reason that Tyler Perry is in Atlanta, not L.A.
Yeah.
God bless him, but he feel more comfortable with his country little self, even with all his millions, millions, millions,
billions,
being down in Atlanta, right? Because it's a different kind of feel and vibe down there. But the successful black people of the South have all been in Atlanta.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm exaggerating a little, but you get
what I'm saying.
It's a majority rule.
I get the gist of what you're saying.
And I don't think I'm crazy when I say that, right?
No.
And when you look at Las Vegas, it is not a city where you've got a lot of wealthy, powerful
black people. Absolutely.
It just don't rock like that here.
Block, you agree with that?
That makes perfect sense.
So what's new with Block, man? We got about 10 minutes, man. I know we went into a whole... What we doing? What's new with Block, man?
All right, man. I got a dope single drop. Now, Block in the Building is a single that I'm very, very proud of. And that push will continue. I got a couple projects with this gentleman right here, Jay Lava. That's Hot Lava Music TV on YouTube and Hot Lava Music on YouTube as well. His channels are dope.
Please subscribe.
My push right now is for a song I got. The video that we were talking about earlier that he filmed entitled Holla at Your Boy.
I love that song, by the way.
Yeah, I know that's his joint. And I have another track that I'm gonna have him shoot for. This one is called Drop It Low.
Okay.
And I've had a lot of people tell me, Block to the Men, that song is a hit. That song is a hit. And I was working with somebody on it, and they didn't really fulfill their end of the bargain. So I had to kind of wait for the contract to expire.
Yes.
That's exactly what happened.
Good.
And so now I'm going to release it independently.
Let's do it.
And Mr. J Lava, High Lava Music TV, is going to shoot the visual for that. And it's going to be dope. And that's going to push. I'm on releasing a lot of singles and shooting a lot of videos right now because I have to get my repertoire.
Yes.
Up.
Gotta get
Block, you was missing.
Out.
You was missing by what? 2 years?
I was missing for 2 years, man. Another snag up of our justice system. Now, do not get me wrong. I definitely believe in our justice system. If my house get robbed,
you call the police.
I'm finna go doot doot doot.
Yeah.
I've been robbed. Woot woot wop. I don't hate police. I don't hate the justices. I don't hate judges. That is the wrong attitude to take.
Yeah.
Our justice system works for us. There's ways for us. We have laws in place as far as the 13th, the 14th, and the 15th amendment. I'm just stating what we have.
Yeah.
Some people think it's not enough, and they might be right, but it's enough for us to fight with. To start the fight with.
Yeah.
Moving on. I went to the joint.
Yeah.
I went to the joint. I was on probation for, you know, getting in the scrap on the street for fighting. You know, I used to be, that's the third time I've been to the joint. But I stayed out the joint for 10 years.
10 years, bro.
10 years. I got out in 2010 and said, I'm done. I'm through. This is not the life. When I went back the second time, I say, no way. It looked like recidivism. It looked like recidivism.
Yeah.
I could see. I looked up, and that's all I could see. That's all I could see is this happening over. I was sitting in my cell one day, and I promise you, I looked up. I looked up, and when I saw the four corner white walls with an electric door, instead of looking up and seeing a painting or looking up and seeing the sky with the clouds, I knew this is recidivism. Mm. And it snapped, and I said, I'm finishing my bid, and I'm through.
I don't want the picture to be me.
That was in 2010, and I stayed out for 10 years. And so I'm going to college. I had started going to college. I'm for culinary.
Yep.
And, you know, I got in a fight, and I just didn't, you know what I'm saying? I'm not thinking nothing of it, but it flipped into something whole other. They tried to use my record against me. And I seen it repeatedly. When I was in there and talking to people and politicking with whites, blacks, Mexicans.
Yeah.
When they look you up they see trouble. That you've been in trouble before.
It's trouble.
When they see that you've been in trouble before. And that you've stayed out for an elongated period of time, they try to wrap you up and throw the book at you to get you back into the system.
Whether you white or black.
Whether you white, black,
or Mexican, Asian.
It's right.
They all the government.
They are
in
the job of incarcerating people.
Yeah.
So black.
And I'm like, man. But, you know, I went out. I got my swole on and shit like that.
Yeah, bro. You always do.
Swole on and shit like that, baby. Learned a lot of stuff. I learned
this
a lot of stuff.
This is my question, though. Mm-hmm. Who the hell want to fight Block? Why?
You know what? It was some guy that, and this is what I had to also learn, because if you use it right, it could be rehabilitatory. It could be rehabilitation.
Yeah.
For the mind and the body.
Of course.
So I ran into a guy that was having a bad day. Mm. And cats like that, you know, and you know, some people, it happens. You get depressed to the point where you're like, I don't even want to live. I don't care what happens in the next couple of moments.
Yeah.
I don't care what happens for the next couple of days.
Yeah.
I'm finna go hit this bottle, and I'm finna do whatever. And I just ran into one of those cats, and I didn't notice it. And I didn't. Now I would notice it because I worked on it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But I didn't notice it, and he was going off the deep end.
Yeah.
And, you know, I said, he was looking at me, and I said something. He said something to me, you know, when I caught his glance. I'm like, what's you... Oh, no, he flew off the handle, and I responded.
Yeah.
Not physically, though.
Yeah.
I responded, and it escalated the situation, and he was the aggressor, actually.
Yeah.
After the conversation escalated, you know, he lunged at me, and I tore his ass up.
Of course.
Tore his ass up, and then he went and played the victim. Like, yes. Oh!
Because there's no cameras
and
now.
And I'm like, this is crazy! How is this happening? He flipped the story on me, and you know what? I really felt like I had been mentally manipulated.
Yes.
The whole time, I'm like,
he played.
How did this happen?
He played. Yeah.
Like, and then it's crazy that you bring that up, because I'm like, I'm thinking about it, and I'm looking at his hospital photo. They showed his hospital when he went to the hospital. He's all like this.
Yeah.
And I'm like,
that wasn't you when we first met.
You knew you couldn't whoop me when you got your ass up.
Yep.
And I'm like, I'll never let that happen again.
Never.
And you know, like I say, ever since 2010, I've been on a straight and narrow, been doing my music, so on and so forth. And so it's not like I was doing what I was doing.
Yeah.
And that was a plus for me. It's not like I was thugging.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Doing what I used to do.
I do want to know, are you and Mouthpiece Cordial, y'all good?
When we see each other, it's like, what's happening? You know, I guess it's just a general respect as a man. You know what I'm saying? Because and this is the cold part about it. I met Mouthpiece behind the wall.
Okay.
That's where I met him.
Yeah.
And we did music. So he's seen me go in.
Yeah.
He's seen me go all the way in.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, And, he was a stand-up guy. So it's like when we see each other, I think that's what we see.
You still remember that.
We still remember that because that's like being in the trenches, baby. Yes. So it's kind of like we'll argue, like maybe on Facebook, or he'll see some and say something, get out of character, or I might say something and get out of character. But when we see each other, it's like, what's happening, man? And then that's about it.
Right. So it'll never be the same.
No.
It's respect.
No. But yeah, it's a general and a overall respect, you know, because I respect him as an artist, and I know he respects me as an artist.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I respect him as a man, and I know he respects me as a man, and that's what we see. Yeah. And you know, it's just
that's
it. You know, that's the end of that.
That's my partner, man. Y'all was rocking.
Yeah, we was rocking him hard. It was closed mouth, don't get fed. And I ripped that. And it's not like I went and threw my clothes away,
right.
Got rid of all the pictures, and I'm just like, this was a pivotal moment in my career.
Yes.
This was a pivotal moment in my career because we recorded, said we was hitting performances and shit. I still got all the pictures.
Yeah.
I still look at them. Yeah. I still got all my closed mouth don't get fed gear, and I still wear it.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, a chick I used to mess with tried to steal. I got a black hoodie with the like teal gold, closed mouth don't get fed. Remember that one?
Yes.
With the like aqua teal, the aqua green, closed mouth don't get fed. And it's dope. And she tried to jack it. I was like, yeah, yo, give me my motherfucking sweater. Hoodie. You give me my sweater rack. You give me my hoodie rack. And it matched it with the aqua green foam posits. Man, that's so I still got all my gear. Those were good times.
Yes.
I remember Crystal Couture and she kind of, you know, moved up. You just branch on. Just branch off. Some people just don't stay. It's like family. Sometimes family does that.
It's seasons, though. You know
what
I mean?
Yeah, you grow up and you grow apart.
This is actually the Vegas family tree, actually.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
When you look at it.
Yes, it is.
Thank you for saying it like that.
Yeah. You just grow up and sometimes you just grow apart.
You do, man.
And that's what happened. That's what happened.
We're still on the same tree.
We didn't see it. We are. That's why we don't see each other and tear each other down.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I've seen Crystal Couture since, because remember, that was us.
Yep.
And we had a hard and adult push. It's just we got to a point to where we had professional differences, and we didn't see eye to eye anymore.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, you know, it just grew off. I've seen her since. It was all love and smiles. We hugged. And,
yeah, man.
And it was good. All love. That's, you know, it's ain't no use to tearing each other down, because that's not going to accomplish anything.
At all, man.
It's not going to accomplish anything. And it's going to tear down what we've already built and what's already happened.
That's a fact.
Because like I said, I still got all them clothes.
Yeah.
I still got all them pictures, and I still look at them, and I still wear it.
Good, man. Is there anything you want to tell the people? First of all, I need them to follow you on Instagram at @block_TO_DA.
Yes.
That's block to the. And also, if you want them to follow you on Facebook, does it matter?
It doesn't matter.
Facebook for family or only? Because some people do that.
No, it's not. Because you know what? It used to kind of be, but then once I started battle rapping, I got a lot of battle artists starting to follow me.
Yep.
So I was like, I'm not going to be able to contain that like that.
So Derek Dixon?
Yeah, Derek D. Dixon, with two I's.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if you're capital or lowercase.
Yeah.
Derek D. Dixon the second.
Yep.
And I also have a block to the page.
Yes.
So
Mr. Hot 16.
I have that. And then I got a backup Facebook page that's block to the.
Okay. Cool.
And then
YouTube. They can find you on YouTube.
Then you can find me on YouTube under the same thing, block to the.
Yeah.
My page is nice. You see all my videos. I have a video on Hot Lava Music TV. That's the Holla at Your Boy block to the Holla at Your Boy video.
Okay.
Like you said, IG. I don't do the Twitter thing. I can't. You know why I don't do Twitter? Because I can't keep up with all of it.
I know.
I got Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. I'm like, man, I can't do it.
It's some of the same people. But look, hey, Block, I'm going to tell everybody watching before we leave, Twitter is not the same fans. It's not the same people.
Right,
so if y'all want different people than Instagram and Facebook, you need to go to Twitter,
because
it's not the same people. What do you want us to know before we get up out of here, bros? What do you want us to know about you, or what do you want to tell the people? Like, you know, give us something. Leave us a gem, anything. Because I didn't get enough time with you.
But we in here. No, man. But we here, though.
Yeah.
Block Sitter is, I'm all about music. I rap. I sing, I act. I was in Born 5, the Matt Damon movie. Yeah. I was an extra, but I was in that Mamma Jamma. I was in that Mamma Jamma. I'm on the credits. I got a SAG creditor for it.
Yeah.
So, you know, but all in all, you know, I was a rapper first.
Yeah.
So I does this music and I rep Las Vegas, Nevada. Check out Las Vegas, Nevada, Las Vegas artists.
Yes.
One of my hashtags is It's the Vague. And I do a lot of, I do something at my events. And I say, I like the crowd to say, who is it? And the crowd goes, who is it? And then I say, it's the Vague.
Absolutely.
It's the Vague, baby.
And that's, you tell everybody, what up, dog?
What up, dog? That's what he's... Lava said that the other day. I hit him like, what up, dog? He said, I didn't... Because I got a new phone, and he was like, I didn't answer. I'm like, why you ain't answer? He said, because I didn't know who it was, nigga. But then you text me, and I see it, and he said, what up, dog? And you the only motherfucker to say, what up, dog? So I knew that was you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Oh, he just... And I want to leave you with this. Barcode Battle League Season City. Be looking for the next event, and you can go check it out on YouTube. You can go check it out on Facebook and Instagram.
Yes.
Pop it. Our first event was dope. Check that out.
And before I get up out of here, make sure you follow me on every single thing. Hot Seat with Icy Jones. Also, my personal music, everything. Icy, J-O-N-E-Z. This is the last day for this month, for this playlist. I'm about to go into a new playlist for the next month. So, you know, get at me. Let me know what's happening. But we're finna have a whole new playlist coming up. We still got Rican, though. Rican is really doing his thing. Rican is doing his thing. Shout out to Rican Joe. But much love to all the artists, man, that's been tapping in and rocking with me, man. Shout out to Deacon T, always coming through with the iconic, man. Lava, appreciate you. We got to get you in here.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I'm definitely down for it.
And,
for sure.
Man, make sure y'all follow Looney Wild as well. That came through earlier with his lit cousin, man, Smoke. All right, we up out of here, man. Room Service Radio, you know what it is, man. I'm here, Hot Seat with Icy Jones, every single Friday, 12 to 2. Let's go.
Oh, boy.
Peace.